All right, Sasrikal students, now we are here to find out the derivation of a formula of resultant R of two vectors A and B. Obviously, we can write like this: resultant A is equal to vector A plus vector B. This is vector A, this is vector B. This is the resultant. How we got the resultant? By completing the parallelogram OQSP. We have extended the line of action of OP vector till point N so that the perpendicular from the head of resultant cuts the extension of OP vector on N. We have also drawn a perpendicular from point P to resultant vector, which cuts the resultant vector at M. So if this angle is 90, this angle is also 90 degree. All right, what we want to do? We intend to find out a relationship of magnitude of resultant. We intend to find out relationship of magnitude of resultant in terms of magnitude of vector A, magnitude of vector B, and the angle between two vectors, that is theta, angle between A and B. All right, so how do we do? Now we'll say, let OP and OQ, they represent two vectors, what? Vector A and vector B. All right, now vector A and vector B both are having angle theta between them. All right, and then using the parallelogram method, we have calculated how we know that vector R resultant is equal to vector A plus vector B. Right, now SN is normal to we can write extension of OP, right? And now we can understand from the geometry of this figure, you just see OS square in this OSN right angle triangle. OS square is hypotenuse, hypotenuse square is equal to base square, ON square plus SN square. So that is SN square plus ON square. But we know that ON is equal to OP plus PN. ON is equal to OP plus PN. So we can always write that. Now we'll see what is equal to ON. Now ON we can also write is equal to OP. Now OP is OP. I'm just saying OP. I'm not saying OP vector. OP is the magnitude of vector A. I can always write magnitude of vector A as OP. I can also write magnitude of vector A as A. In some textbooks, I can also write magnitude of vector A as vector A modulus. We are all same, right? So ON is equal to OP. Now, if you see OP is equal to the magnitude of vector A is A, OP. So I can write this is equal to OP is equal to A. And what is PN? PN. Now, if you say PN, now this vector is B, so this vector is also B. This vector, PS vector, is same as OQ vector. The direction is same and their magnitude is also same because opposite sides of a parallelogram are same. Very right. So now if this angle, corresponding angle, this is theta, then this is also theta. So in this right angle triangle SPN, I can see that I can find the value for PN. How? We know that PN by PS is equal to, PN by PS is equal to cos theta. Base by hypotenuse. Now PN, then PN is equal to PS. PS is magnitude of vector B, which I can write as simply B cos theta. So I'll write here B cos theta. Remember, A and B are not vectors here. All right. Now just see SN. SN. What is SN? I can write SN is equal to B sine theta. SN is equal to B sine theta because this is the perpendicular, is equal to B sine theta. Very right. So I can write OS square is equal to what? SN square. SN square means B square sine square theta plus ON square. ON square is A plus B cos theta whole square. Well, this is equal to, use another ink, this is equal to B square sine square theta plus, this is my first term A square, this is my second term B cos theta. So B square cos square theta plus 2AB, 2 into first into second term, 2AB cos theta. Well, this is equal to, if you take sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. So B square is common. And then sine square theta plus cos square theta plus sine square theta, which is equal to 1 plus A square plus 2AB cos theta. So from this I get, now what is OS? OS is a magnitude of vector R. We can, which I can represent by R. OS is equal to R square is equal to, I can rewrite A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta, which will give me the first answer. R is equal to A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta under root. Why? Resultant, I'm omitting the negative sign because resultant is a positive quantity, right? And this is, if it was a vector, yes, vector can be negative, but resultant, a line segment length cannot be negative. So I say resultant is positive quantity. I have omitted negative sign. So my first answer is derived that I have successfully expressed resultant in terms of A, B and theta. Now you just see in triangle OSN. Just see in triangle OSN, we can write SN is equal to OS sine alpha. Triangle OSN, OSN, whole thing, SN. SN divided by OS is sine alpha. That's why SN is equal to OS sine alpha. Very right. Now, what is OS? OS is the magnitude of resultant, that is R sine alpha, right? And you see, if you just see triangle PSN, just see PSN. Here I can write SN. SN by this is equal to sine theta. So I can always say that SN is equal to, now what is this? PS. PS is this vector B. So I can say this is B sine theta. From this both are equal to SN. I can say R sine alpha is equal to B sine theta. From this, what I get is R divided by sine theta is equal to B divided by sine alpha. 70% work is done. All right. Similarly, if you just see now, just see what is sine alpha. Sine alpha. Now, if you talk about sine alpha, can I write PM is equal to A sine alpha? How? You just see PM. Now, this is PM. Now, this is PM, and I'm taking this right angle triangle. in this right angle triangle, if you see, always hypotenuse is opposite to 90 degree, which is the longest side of a right angle triangle. OP is a hypotenuse, vector A is a hypotenuse, so I can always say PM. PM divided by this, PM by A is equal to sine alpha. Very right. But at the same time, PM in this right angle triangle, PMS. Here, this is a hypotenuse, so I can say PM is equal to what? PS sine beta. PS, because PS is a hypotenuse. So PS is what? B, I can write here. B sine beta. Very right. From there, I will get what? A divided by sine beta is equal to B divided by sine alpha. Well, B divided by sine alpha is equal to R by sine theta. B divided by sine alpha is also equal to A by sine beta. From here, I get a formula. R by sine theta is equal to B by sine alpha is equal to A by sine beta. Very right. So my other part is also done. What A by sine theta? What is R? Magnitude of resultant sine theta. What is theta? Angle between two vectors. B by sine alpha is equal to A by sine beta. Very right. Quickly, I can also understand that sine alpha. Just see. Sine alpha is equal to B divided by R sine theta. Hope you understand this. Sine alpha is equal to B by R sine theta. Just see what is, so cross multiplication can also give us R sine alpha is equal to B sine theta. How we got it? R sine alpha. Now this is R sine alpha. When we take R sine alpha, obviously we are taking OSN. So what is R sine alpha is SN. And what is B sine theta from this? B sine theta is also SN. They are both equal to SN. When they are both equal to, I can always, here R, if somebody says, if I want to find out alpha angle. Now alpha angle is the angle between resultant and one vector. So simply this formula will do. B R sine theta. Theta is already given. B vector magnitude is already given. Resultant already we have calculated from this formula. So we can find out the alpha also. We can also have it. Or just see. Tan alpha would be equal to what? Tan alpha. See, tan alpha in this triangle OSN, that is perpendicular divided by base. We can write SN divided by what? SN divided by ON. Now SN is what? SN is, we know that B sine theta. We know that SN is B sine theta. Already we know that, which is equal to OP plus PN. ON is OP plus PN. What is OP? OP is A. And what is PN? PN is B cos theta. So you can find out alpha by this method, B by R sine theta, or you can find alpha by this. Alpha would be tan inverse of this thing. Students, to see more videos, see our YouTube channel, Learn CBSE. I wish you